Hi, my name is Peter, and today, on behalf of Pangolin Laser Systems, I'll be showing you how to use the new automatic distributed scanning technology.
Distributed scanning is a great way to get more complex laser graphics at higher refresh rates through the use of more laser projectors automatically, rather than the more time-consuming method of manually dividing content over multiple laser projectors. Before distributed scanning, the entire image could be either split over projectors based on the position, so there would be always moments where one projector would be doing most of the work. Or the animation would need to be manually drawn over multiple projectors, which, amid more than two systems, can be very confusing and rapidly time-consuming. Distributed scanning technology automatically determines the amount of points per laser projector. The minimum amount of points per projector is 500 points. Over every increase of 500, the content will be passed on to the next laser projector until there's no more projectors available. Once there are no more projectors available, the point count will be added up to all projectors. To get started, we need to make sure of the following things. 1. Projectors of equal brightness, color balance, and beam quality. If we do not have these things, we will see when other projectors take over the image. You can learn more about setting your color balance by watching the video Advanced Color Palette Settings and Beyond. 2. You need to make sure your projectors are tuned to the ILDA test pattern, making sure that the blue circle is inside the green square. We also need to make sure that the color shift is set correctly. The color shift can be set correctly by looking at the space in between the dividing line. It should be equal. That way, the color timings of every projector is correct and we have no tills or disconnects. The image needs to be equally overlapping and geometric correction needs to match. If we don't do this, we'll get disconnections or deformed images. 3. You need FP4 hardware to do this. A QM2000 or FP3 will not work. Before starting with the demonstration, there are a few things to consider. Since we are making use of mechanical devices to scan the image, we have a few things like thermal drift and resolution limitations. These shouldn't be a problem unless we're talking about very far distances. In general, the mechanical properties of laser projectors will smooth out resolution problems. If this is an issue, a way to circumvent the thermal drift is to run your laser projector at 0% brightness scanning images for a while. Getting started. In this demonstration, I'll be showing you how to set up the laser projectors for distributed scanning.
So what you want to do first is go to your projector settings and shift click to select all. Just click back and forth. Set all projectors from 50 by 50 to 100 by 100 to get the full angle of projection. Now we want to go to our settings again and go to our projection zones. We click that. And so how I have it set up is for every projector, I have a zone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, going to each projector set separately, as you can see. So what I want to do is I want to distribute all content that goes to the zone projector 1 to projector 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So how I would do that is first, I have to set up the geometric correction to overlap each other because the content needs to be fitting inside of the same image. So what I want to do is bring up projector number 1 and I will make a rough square with this. So let me just set that up. Okay, just make a rough zone here. And that seems about right. You can also use your mouse and the arrow keys to set this up. John Ward has a really good guide on this. I will mention, or I will put a link in the description, which you can follow along, because to save time on the video, I will be speeding up part of this setup. So what I want to we'll want to be doing is bring up a grid. The grid helps you to overlap the entire projection zone correctly. So what I'm going to do is match each zone and make them overlap. Also, please spend your time on this because it's really needed. It's a very precise alignment thing. And you can reduce the brightness if it helps you align it because it's going to get really bright. I will fast forward the video to save time and Once you've got it set up where all projectors overlap, we can follow on to the next step. Okay, I'll call this done. So now if you overlap all of them, you can see it's one really bright image. So now what we want to do is we want to disable all these zones on this, and we want to go to distribution. So once we select distribution, we get an option of some projectors here. These are only FP4 projectors that we can use. So what we want to do is we want to add all these projectors. The order technically doesn't matter, but it's what Beyond's going to be using to distribute to an order. So we click enable distributed scanning. We should see a little arrow, two arrows pointing. And if you click OK now, and we project something complex or just something in general to our projector number one, it will start distributing that content over multiple projectors. I'll grab a better example. I'll grab the city. I'll set it to projector number one. And now it will distribute this content over multiple projectors automatically. Make sure that the color shift on all your projectors is set equally. So make sure that you go to your size and position or scan rate, sorry, and make sure that color shift is equal in everything. So make sure you open your test, your ILA test pattern, and check the spacing between those lines, between the lines I will point out in the video. Those need to be evenly spaced in between. If the timing is anywhere off, then lines will start also disconnecting and things will just look wrong. So as you can see now, the lines are nicely connecting. All right, that will be it for this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.